Good morning. My name is Mary Kim Oliver, and as Vice President of Student Affairs for Durham College, it's my distinct honor to welcome you today and officially call our 2017 Spring Convocation to order. I'd like to start this morning by acknowledging that we are hosting this morning's ceremony on the traditional territory of the Mississaugas of Scugog Island First Nation. And on behalf of the entire Durham College community, welcome to all of our graduates, your families, your friends, and special guests, as well as to all of those watching live via the internet. I'd like to now ask everyone who is able to continue standing and to join in singing our national anthem. Today, students from the Schools of Interdisciplinary Studies and Media, Art, and Design, or MAD, are receiving their credentials. As you may notice, the staff and faculty members from MAD are carrying yellow roses in honor of their friend and colleague, Jerry Rose. For those who may not know, Professor Gerald Rose was the editor-in-chief of The Chronicle, the campus newspaper at Durham College and UOIT, for more than two decades. He retired on June 30th, 2014, exactly 23 years after he started at Durham. Sadly, he passed away in January of this year at the age of 67. Much loved by students and colleagues alike, Jerry will be missed but always remembered. Convocation has always been one of the most important events of the year, and it is even more so in 2017. As we are not only celebrating the achievements of our students, but also the college's 50th anniversary. Our anniversary theme is the start of something amazing, which is very apt when you consider the reason that we're here today. As students, you have demonstrated incredible commitment, coupled with hard work and determination, which will culminate as you cross the stage to accept your credential. For some, this may be your first post-secondary diploma or certificate. For others, it may be your second or third. But for all of you, consider today the start of your something amazing. Being able to cross the convocation stage is a great accomplishment that deserves recognition. So let us take a minute to acknowledge that fact with a round of applause for our graduates. To our guests, I strongly encourage you to celebrate and cheer for your graduate as they cross the stage. And it is now my privilege to introduce our platform party. I would ask that each member stand and remain standing as their name is called, and that our audience holds its applause until all of the names have been announced. Rebecca Milburn, Associate Vice President, Academic. Bart Lusick, Board of Governors. Debbie McKee Demchuk, Board of Governor. Heather Quantrill, Board of Governors. Kevin Griffin, Board of Governors. Paul Macklin, Board of Governors. Barbara McShane, Chief Financial Officer. Kevin Baker, Principal of the Whitby Campus. Linda Marco, Associate Vice President, Office of Development and Alumni Affairs, and President of the Durham College Foundation. Scott Blakey, Chief Administrative Officer. Paul Bishop, Executive Director and Registrar for Strategic Enrollment Services. Stephanie Ball, Executive Dean, School of Interdisciplinary Studies and School of Justice and Emergency Services. Elaine Popp, Vice President, Academic. Don Loviza, President. Dan Borowick, Vice Chair, Board of Governors. Rob Leth, our guest speaker. Elaine Garnett, Vice President, Durham College Alumni Association. Joyce Hunter, Alumni of Distinction. And Greg Murphy, Executive Dean, School of Media, Art and Design. Ladies and gentlemen, your platform party. I would now like to call on Dan Borowick, Vice Chair of the Durham College Board of Governors, who will bring greetings on behalf of the board.
Thank you, Mary Kim, and good morning, everyone. It gives me great pleasure to be here today representing the Durham College Board of Governors. On behalf of the entire board, I would like to extend my sincere congratulations to the graduating class of 2017. As you prepare to cross the convocation stage, take a look around at the family, friends, special guests, and many of Durham College's employees who are all here to share in this momentous achievement with you. You've worked incredibly hard to get here, and while today is an ending, it is also a beginning. And you're celebrating that beginning as Durham College celebrates its 50th anniversary. In both milestones, the past has played a vital role in the shaping of the present, which in turn will have a profound impact on the future. So whether you are continuing in your studies or are launching your career, know that the future looks bright. Success matters, and we as a Board of Governors work diligently to ensure you receive the best post-secondary experience during your time as a student. We hope you will take the knowledge and skills you have learned and use them to achieve the success you so greatly deserve. If you tackle what lies ahead with the focus, determination, and commitment you have already demonstrated by earning your credential, there will be no stopping you. And no matter where your path takes you, we hope you will cherish the memories you have made and always remember today's ceremony, not only as the culmination of years of hard work, but also the start of something amazing. To the Durham College class of 2017, congratulations and good luck.
Thank you, Dan. I would now like to welcome Durham College President Don Loviza to the podium.
Thank you, Mary Kim. Good morning. It is my pleasure to welcome you to today's convocation ceremony. To our guests who are here today to help us celebrate, please know that everyone at Durham College shares your pride as we recognize the accomplishments of our graduating class of 2017. And to our graduates, on behalf of the entire Durham College community, please accept our sincere congratulations on reaching this amazing milestone. This is the ninth year that I've had the pleasure of speaking at convocation ceremonies, and I can say with certainty that there's nothing more inspiring than the promise of a graduating class. This is especially true in our 50th year, a year in which we're celebrating five decades of Durham College graduates, and a milestone in our institution's history. From our very first convocation ceremony in 1969, when 53 students crossed the stage to accept their diplomas, to more than 3,800 students who are receiving their credentials this week, we've come a long way. Each year, when it comes time to put pen to paper, you know, I ask myself, what do our graduates want or need to hear from their college president? What words will they find meaning in? What will inspire them as we celebrate the dedication, hard work, and talent that has brought them to this day? Against the backdrop of our 50th anniversary, I've considered just how far we've come since 1967. And with this in mind, it seems fitting to revisit some of the words of wisdom offered by Durham College's very first president, Dr. Gordon E. Willey. His comments are from the college's early years, but are remarkably relatable to the reality of today. I would like to share with you three key pieces of advice from Dr. Willey about the value of people, the importance of lifelong learning, and the significance of doing for ourselves and for others. Before I begin, though, I would like to invite the graduating class of 2017 to join me in a quick look back before we look forward. In 1969, as members of our first graduating class accepted their credentials, the average income in Canada was $14,000 a year. Gas was 7.4 cents per liter. Minimum wage was $1.46, and you could buy yourself a new car for $2,700. The Beatles had made their last public performance, and Neil Armstrong was the first man to land on the moon. And the leader of our great country was a man with the last name Trudeau. Durham College was just 2 years young after opening its doors in September 1969, with 205 students learning in 16 portable classrooms. Known as a growing college even then, we were focused on putting people first, something we continue to pride ourselves on today. Durham College was an organization dedicated to providing students with the best possible education in their chosen fields, an organization proud to be your community college, something that is just as true today and meaningful today as it was back then. Our philosophy always was and still remains to be hands-on. In 1969, Dr. Willey envisioned this hands-on approach to education for students as, and I quote, a process focused on everyday working situations in their field, chosen fields, enabling them to appreciate the things their future employers will require from them in the performance of their duties, end of quote. Fast forward to 2017, I'm incredibly proud to say that this has not changed. If anything, our commitment to hands-on approach to education and providing students with experiential learning opportunities has only grown over time. Now, from a social and cultural perspective, even as things change, today's headlines echo the past. We've just seen the last public performance of another iconic rock band, the Tragically Hip. Space travel is no longer limited to NASA and instead involves companies like Virgin and Amazon. And the leader of our great country is a man with the last name Trudeau, 50 years later. At Durham College, we now serve 30,000 full and part-time students. And we offer more than 140 full-time programs and hundreds of continuing education and online courses. We employ more than 1,800 people. We've been a GTA top employer for the past 6 years and proudly register an economic impact to the Durham region of $816 million annually. My cold's getting the best of me. Whether it's our students, alumni, or employees, there's virtually nowhere in the region that our presence is not felt. And the connections that we have built continue to positively impact the social, cultural, and economic well-being of the communities that we live, work, and play. We're incredibly proud of these contributions, all of which are intrinsically linked to the first of Dr. Willey's insights that I'd like to share with you today. That's the value of people. To quote Dr. Willey, not too long ago, I was reading about computers. And there was a paragraph noting that the best computers had been in the market for centuries. Every model was different, and they were continually under development. The human being is still the most expensive, non-linear, all-purpose computing system that has ever been devised and will continue to be so. A modern electronic computer is a handy gadget, but it has its shortcomings. If you put garbage into it, only garbage will return from it. It has no conscience, no ambition, no courage, and no spirit, end of quote. If you consider his words closely, his message is less about technology and more about people, and more important, the qualities that each of us possess. We know technology is changing at a rapid pace, and with it, a strong emphasis to match its pace in the workplace. But even still, with the pace at which we live, we must remember that human qualities like creativity, compassion, integrity, intuition can never be replaced. Graduates, now is the time to be confident that nothing, not a computer, not a machine, not even another human being will ever compare to you and the unique qualities that you possess. At the same time, I encourage you to recognize, much like the college has done in the past 50 years, that the progress of technology can also benefit us. When we work in partnership with technology, we develop ways to allow it to work for us, to provide positive change in our society, and to connect us with one another around the world like never before. With that framework in mind, it is my hope that you're leaving Durham College with the understanding that the more you put into the world, the more you'll get back. The second insight I'd like to share with you is about the importance of lifelong learning. 50 years ago, with wisdom far beyond his years, Dr. Willis said, "No matter which avenue you are taking, it is well to remember that you must continue the learning process for the rest of your lives. Or, in this day and age, you'll soon be left obsolete. It's now time for you to have a purpose," end of quote. In 2017, nothing could be closer to the truth. And although a convocation marks the conclusion of your formal studies at Durham College, it's only one of the many steps you'll take on your path to success. It certainly does not mark the end of your learning journey. It is through ongoing learning that you'll expand your mind, rid yourself of assumptions, allow yourself to be open for new information, and ultimately find your purpose. There's a good chance that most people you'll meet will know something that you don't. So resist the temptation to remain in your comfort zone, and instead, make the decision to stop, reflect, and find new ways to develop and expand your way of thinking. In the end, much like technology, your credential is a tool that can help you get to where you want to go, but of equal importance are those personal qualities I spoke of: integrity, creativity, compassion, and innovation, as well as your ability to stay curious and keep learning. Your success both in life and your career depends on it. And finally, I'd like to focus on the significance of doing for yourselves and for others. Again, Dr. Willis said, "Let me emphasize this point about doing things. In my language, it means work. And it's my belief that man," now keep in mind this is the 60s, "is intended to work. This is a working universe, and everything on Earth performs work. The Earth will not tolerate any deadbeats and those who try to find themselves out of step with the universe." So in Dr. Willis' 1967 words, I quote, "Don't be a deadbeat. Instead, find your purpose and take action. Life might always be perfect or turn out as you imagine, but now is your chance to seize new opportunities that you have created. Volunteer. Make plans. Work hard. And always, always keep pushing forward. The world is changing rapidly, and quite frankly, can use all the help it can get. And during your time at Durham College, each of you have proven that you're willing to work hard, that you have what it takes to succeed. I encourage you to take that motivation and drive that got you here today and use it to do good things. Get engaged in business, in community, in government, and more. Be someone who's willing to work hands-on, who solves problems, who makes the most of the opportunities that come your way. Be honest about yourself, your skills, your interests, and your values. And use that knowledge to motivate yourself, to take the next steps in your life, wherever that might be. Class of 2017, I am more than confident that each of you is capable of leading in new and exciting ways. And today, you join a network of alumni, individuals with whom you can share your triumphs and challenges. As you begin your career and life beyond campus, I hope you stay connected, including returning to Durham College this fall as we celebrate 5 decades of success at our 50th anniversary homecoming in September. This will be the ultimate party where we'll bring together the best of the decades with a week-long celebration. Until then, on behalf of all of us at Durham College, I wish you much happiness and success. Remember your value. Keep learning. Find your purpose, take action, and the rest will fall into place. Good luck and have fun. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Don. Before I introduce our Alumni Association speaker, I'd like to ask our graduates just to take a moment to consider the relationships that you've built during your time as a student, relationships that are the first of many you will form over the course of your career. It's important to remember that those relationships do not end upon graduation, they evolve. Once you've crossed the convocation stage, you become a member of the Durham College Alumni Association family, It is wide-reaching, and there is no part of the community where you will not find Durham College alumni. In fact, there are more than 53,000 Durham College graduates living and working in the Durham region alone. With that, please join me in welcoming Elaine Garnett, class of 1990 and vice president of the Alumni Association, who will bring greetings on behalf of the association.
Thank you, Mary Kim, and good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Durham College Alumni Association, I would like to congratulate the spring graduating class of 2017. As Mary Kim said, my name is Elaine Garnett, and I am so pleased to be here as Vice President of the Alumni Association. Like you, I am also from Media Arts and Design, and I stand here as a proud graduate of the advertising program from 1990. Thank you. I take pride in welcoming this morning's graduates to the Durham College alumni family, a family that as of today is over 81,000 members strong. Our alumni can be found enjoying successful careers and contributing to their communities across the globe. They have taken the skills and knowledge gained during their time as a Durham College student and have created amazing personal and professional lives for themselves. In recognition of that excellence, we will be presenting three Alumni of Distinction Awards this year. This award honors the extraordinary contributions our alumni make to society while achieving career success. They all work in different fields, but Durham College is the one thing that binds them together. Each fondly remembers their time as a student, learning both inside and outside the classroom. If you could please direct your attention to the screen, I would like to introduce this year's Alumni of Distinction Award recipients.
The guidance from the faculty was instrumental to my success while I was at Durham College. The sense of community that's fostered by the college was inspirational that I carried through to the R-loop concept. And the diversity of thinking and students at the college was really eye-opening and was also a large source of inspiration for the R-loop platform.
I knew I wanted to get into business, but it focused me on marketing, and I gravitated towards that, and it helped me identify what it is that I wanted to do when I graduated.
I was always an insatiably curious kid. I was one of those kids that followed people around. Where are you going? What are you doing? Can I come with you? And it just really made sense when I found the journalism program at Durham to apply and take the program. And it's given me a really good foundation for the technical skills attached to connecting with people, researching, writing, interviewing, and producing content.
My two pieces of advice for grads. The first one would be, it's not what you learn. It's how you deal with adversity and the challenges that really determine the path of your life and where you end up. The second piece of advice is to be comfortable with the uncomfortable. Especially in this world, I think where there's so much opportunity, there's so much unknown. So what needs to be birthed into the world are new solutions and new perspectives.
This distinction to me means that my college recognizes the importance of the work that I and others like me have done, because I wouldn't have got here without my mentors at the college and then also in the newsrooms that I worked at coming up through the years. And if you're a little bit different and bounce to the beat of a different drum, one day you will find that very likely that is going to become your strength.
Identify your passion and devote yourself to it entirely. Pour all of your efforts into that passion and you will undoubtedly be successful with the work that you are doing. And the second would be to not fear change and to embrace innovation and outside of the box thinking. Ultimately, what it boils down to, I think, is being the change that you want to see in the world.
I would now like to present Joyce Hunter, a 2003 graduate of the Journalism Print Program, with her Alumni of Distinction Award.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Joyce. Graduates, as you can see, your relationship with Durham College does not end because you're no longer a student. It is evolving. As you tackle whatever comes next, I encourage you to stay in touch with the college and the Alumni Association. We love hearing about your successes and what's happening in your lives. As a member of the Durham College Alumni Association, you also have access to a number of benefits, of which I encourage you to take advantage. You can find details about the many benefits available to you on our website. So congratulations again on your graduation, and all the best as you embark on your future journey to success. Thank you.
Thank you, Eileen. I am now pleased to welcome this morning's guest speaker. Rob Leth graduated with an Award of Merit from Durham College's journalism program in 1996. He now works at Global News as a sports anchor. His passion for athletics has informed his career both on and off the field, and following graduation, he pursued sports broadcasting. Over the course of his career, he has worked for various news outlets, including Rogers Television and Global. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Rob Leth.
All right, so before I start, I'm going to go off script already. I just want to try a little experiment. Since we're in an arena where yelling and screaming and cheering is encouraged, I just want to hear from the graduates. How do you feel today about earning your diplomas? All right, that's not bad. I think this next one will be a little louder, though. Parents, friends, family, how are you feeling about these kids on the floor? All right, we're off to a good start. Well, it's a huge honor for me to be here today, and it's hard to believe that it's now been 21 years since I was sitting where you are today without air conditioning, wondering what the heck am I going to do with my life? And I should mention that my wife, Donna, she's a graduate as well from Durham College from the nursing program, but obviously watching sports for a living is way more important than saving lives, so that's why I'm up here talking to you today. Now, I've been an on-air personality at Global News since 2003, but my career path began at Durham College back in the fall of 1994 when I enrolled as a student in the journalism program. Over the first year, we learned how to write stories, proper layout techniques, interview skills, and for some reason, how to develop film in a darkroom, because that's a skill that will never, ever go out of date. The biggest and most fun part of being in the journalism program was working on the school newspaper, the Durham Chronicle. My most memorable interview came in year one when news broke that Cuban basketball star Augusto Duquesne had defected during the World Basketball Championships in Toronto and was coming to Durham as a student and to play for the Durham Lords. As soon as he was on campus, I arranged for an interview with him at the athletic complex. For whatever reason, it hadn't occurred to me that there might be a bit of a language barrier. My first question to him was along the lines of, Augusto, how does it feel for you to be here at Durham College? His response was nothing more than a smile and a blank stare. So it was off to a good start. Fortunately, I had athletic director Ken Babcock there with me to translate. So after I asked my question and got no response, Ken jumped in and said, Augusto, how does it feel to be here at Durham College? Does it feel good? Oh, yeah, good. Needless to say, there was a lot of paraphrasing in the article that appeared in the Chronicle. And it read something like, Duquesne says it feels great to be here at Durham College and is looking forward to leading the Durham Lords to an OCAA championship. Now, speaking of the Durham Lords, I was also a proud member of the men's baseball team for the 2 years I was here, which was a lot of fun. In my first season, I played well enough to earn the Rookie of the Year award, which is still a huge honor for me. And in year two, I'll never forget my last play as a competitive baseball player. We were playing in the Final Four in Guelph. We weren't able to win the championship, but playing in the third place game, we were winning by one run in the final inning. The other team had the tying run on third base with only one out, and the batter hit a fly ball to me in left field. I made the catch and fired a perfect strike to the plate, for the double play to end the game and to win the bronze medal. After the baseball season had finished, all of the focus for the rest of the school year was on the Chronicle. There were a lot of late nights as we worked together to meet deadlines, but again, it was a lot of fun. I wrote articles on all of the Durham Lords sports teams, featured several of the top athletes, and even reported regularly on the Oshawa Generals, who didn't play here, but at the Civic, including a feature on Mark Savard, who went on to have a stellar career in the NHL. When I graduated with my journalism degree, which was a print journalism degree, by the way, there were two jobs that I really wanted. I either wanted to be a sports writer for the Toronto Sun or a sports writer for the Toronto Star. Unfortunately, neither seemed to be hiring at the time, and the only opening was for a reporter at a local paper in Wasega Beach. So 2 years later, after dead-end jobs, digitizing photos, and telemarketing for a stock brokerage firm, I decided to start volunteering at Rogers Television here in Oshawa. With my print journalism degree already in hand, I learned the technical side of television fairly quickly, and before long, I was hired as a videographer covering the local sports scene for the community news program called Plugged In, which was later rebranded as First Local. In 2001, Rogers was so happy with what they saw in Oshawa that they decided to launch a sports department in Richmond Hill and asked me to help launch it as a sports producer. What I didn't realize was, by sports department, they meant just me. In the summer of 2003, while covering a celebrity golf tournament in Vaughan, I got my big break. One of the foursomes in the tournament just happened to be a group from Global Sports, including longtime sports anchor Jim Taddy. I decided to approach Jim and ask him if I could send him a demo reel. 1 week later, we both happened to arrive at the Molson Indy in Toronto, now the Honda Indy, at the exact same time. And he must have thought I was stalking him or something, as we picked up our media credentials. He said he liked my tape and to give him a call. And a week after that, I was learning to edit NHL highlight packs for Global Sports. I was eventually hired on as a videographer slash reporter, and my first assignment was to cover a Toronto Maple Leaf playoff game against the Philadelphia Flyers. My job was to get interviews in the Flyers' room after the game. The first player to come out was Keith Primeau, who was 6'5", 220 pounds. I was eager to make a positive first impression and quickly made my way to the front and middle of the scrum, which is where you want to be. Since there were so many cameras and reporters in the room from both Toronto and Philadelphia, the Flyers PR guy thought it would be a great idea to have Primeau stand on a milk crate so that all of the cameras had a clear shot of him. So there I was in the front middle with Primeau on the milk crate with his waist right about here on me. He was only wearing a towel. And I thought, well, isn't this a glamorous job? Over the years, I've had the chance to cover some great events, including two Super Bowls, playoff games for the Leafs, Raptors, and Blue Jays, the Leafs outdoor games in Ann Arbor, Michigan and BMO Field, the Canadian Open golf tournaments at Glen Abbey in Oakville and Royal Montreal. But right at the top of the list for me has to be the 2011 Masters in Augusta, Georgia. On the Wednesday of that week, one day before the tournament began, I walked outside the clubhouse, and standing under the giant oak tree, all by himself, wearing his green jacket, was the legend himself, Arnold Palmer. If you don't know the golfer, you probably know the beverage. I walked up to him and politely asked if he wouldn't mind if I asked him a few questions. And even though I wasn't prepared for it, it turned out to be the most memorable interview of my career. Aside from being a sports anchor and sports reporter for Global News, for a few years, I was also a reporter in news, developing a niche for doing the quirky, lighter side of the news, designed to make you laugh, or at the very least, to make you smile. My most infamous moment came on the first day of March break in 2008. March break was notable that year in Toronto because it had snowed quite a bit, and spring was still nowhere to be seen. So my assignment for that day was to get a stopwatch, find some kids enjoying their time off, and find out which sled was the fastest that year. Now, as is often the case when reporters get their stories, my cameraman and I thought, well, this is a dumb story. But we headed out anyway and tried to make the most of it. We headed to the giant hill at Riverdale Park at the base of the Don Valley Parkway, and ended up finding two guys, both around 20 years old, both about the same height and weight, and both with identical snow tubes. So the idea was I would have them race each other down the hill, and when the one guy, Reuben, slowed down at the bottom, I would fall on top of him and say something funny. What we should have done was a test run. As they started down the hill, I began my ill-fated stand-up on camera. Here they come down the hill. It looks like Reuben is in the lead. After that, everything was a blur. Reuben wasn't slowing down. In fact, he was gaining speed. At the last second, I realized my only hope was to try and jump over him. I got about 2 inches off the ground before the snow tube struck my feet, propelling me high into the air, and I still remember being upside down and wondering why the sky was below the ground. When I finally landed, almost completing a full 360-degree spin, I landed facing the camera with the microphone lying right in front of me. Knowing that the video of the flip had to be somewhat incredible, I knew I had to say something. So I picked up the mic and said, "That was a bad idea." At Riverside Park, Rob Leth, Global News. Thank you, I guess. Just by applause, again, who has seen this video? Who knows what I'm talking about? A proud moment. Needless to say, the video went viral. It appeared on Ellen, Oprah, The Tonight Show, Tosh.0, and even won Jimmy Kimmel's Video of the Year. It even appeared during the opening credits of an Elizabeth Banks movie last year called, appropriately enough, Walk of Shame. I've only seen the opening credits of that movie. Now, on a more serious note, before I leave you today, there are a couple of people I would like to recognize. First of all, Mr. Sam Dempster. Mr. Dempster was not only my baseball coach at Durham College, he was also my baseball coach at Eastdale Collegiate here in Oshawa. Before attending Eastdale, I also made brief stops at other high schools, including G.L. Roberts, O'Neill, R.S. McLaughlin, and Central Collegiate. The thing was, I had a slight issue with attendance. I was never a bad kid. In fact, most of the time I was skipping school. I was usually playing baseball with two of my other friends who didn't exactly like school all that much either. But when I got to Eastdale, they had a baseball team, and the rule was simple. If you didn't go to class, you didn't get to play on the team. Mr. Dempster spent a ton of time with us, even in the winter, working on our baseball skills in the gym, all the while making sure that we made it to class. After finally learning the importance of work ethic, that carried right over into the college, into Durham College, and still applies today, I just want to say thank you, Mr. Dempster. And most importantly, I would also like to say thank you to my professor at Durham College, Mr. Jerry Rose. Jerry was not only a great teacher, but also a wonderful, wonderful human being. I still remember one of the first assignments that I didn't get done on time. I gave him some long, rambling excuse, and he just said, "Okay. So you'll still accept it?" I said, "Sure." "What sort of mark can I expect?" "Zero. You didn't make the deadline." And Jerry didn't say it in a way that was condescending or mean-spirited. He just made it clear that if you want to succeed in this business, you absolutely can never afford to miss your deadline. The other thing I loved about Jerry was his very dry sense of humor and quick wit. Jerry wasn't what you would call a large man, probably in the neighborhood of 150 pounds, and I might be being generous there. On one memorable blustery day at the college, he was about to leave, and I said, "Jerry, you can't go out there. You're gonna blow away." He just looked at me and said, "Nope, cut right through it." Sadly, as you heard earlier, we lost Jerry earlier this year to cancer, but I know he was loved by all of his students and by his peers, and was the heart and soul of the Durham Chronicle for 23 wonderful years. Without Jerry's guidance, there's no way I'd be enjoying the career I've had to this point, so thank you, Jerry. As for all of you, be proud of what you've accomplished. You're rewarded today for all of the hard work you've put in. And even if you don't know yet, like me, where your path will lead, an education can never be taken away from you. Congratulations, and best of luck on your journey. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rob. I would now like to welcome Dr. Elaine Popp, Vice President Academic, to commence the conferring of diplomas and certificates.
Thank you, Mary Kim. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present the 2017 graduating class of Durham College. I certify that each graduate has met all of the academic requirements for the credential they are about to receive. They have conducted their studies with diligence and merit our congratulations. We will now commence the presentation of diplomas and certificates.
Ladies and gentlemen, Stephanie Ball, Executive Dean of the School of Interdisciplinary Studies, will present the diplomas and certificates for the School of Interdisciplinary Studies. Brittany Chiligarian, highest ranking graduate. General Arts and Science, Chelsea Betancourt. Josh Campbell. Emily Dark. Vijay Divya. Jordan Estevez. Jeffrey Gear. Jessica Halliday. Jennifer Hammond. Shelly Curis. Samantha Lemus. Carly Lunn. Elokitha Mathilagan. Kara Morrison. Anna Noonan. Lori Palmer. Cassandra Price. Frank Restuxia. Tashana Russell. Natasha Spencer. Shelby Yeoman Reed. Ladies and gentlemen, That concludes the graduates from the School of Interdisciplinary Studies. Ladies and gentlemen, Greg Murphy, Executive Dean of the School of Media, Arts, and Design, will now present the diplomas and certificates for the School of Media, Art, and Design.
Advertising and Marketing Communications, Brandon Agnew. Rachel Alexander. Angela Benesley. Zachary Beauparla. Anovki Bovzar. Brandon Clark. Kayla Cook. Jamika Cruikshank Malcolm. Natalie DeRoche. Charlotte Edwards. Madeline Grixty. Yannick Green. Stephanie Hanna. Leanne Howarth, highest ranking graduate. Sarah Jane Impolito. Natasha Koo. Lijo Joseph. Samantha Malia. Alyssa Matthew. Megan McDonald. Ashley McGregor. Katie Miss Kelly. Louisa Malloy. Alex Powder. Olivia Norris. Alex Rich. Kayla Richardson. Madeline Riley. Alex Royer. Bethany Seaton. Rachel Thompson. Paige Toll. George Salavutis. Georgina Tutsos. Marissa Turpin. Alexandra Weeks. Rachel Wendt. Travis Yule.
Animation Digital Arts. Corey Canarella. Alex Cowell. Evan Jules. Nora Pizzali. Animation Digital Production. Tyler Byback. Alicia Costoza. Brandon Dearlove, highest ranking graduate. Caroline Estabrooks. Victoria Etherington Phillips. Alexander Krezin. Montgomery Martin. Matthew Mead. Kayla Reimer. Elora Rosenberg. Tara Tote. Leanne Tremblay. Amanda Wilkins. Spencer Wyatt. Jordan Xavier. Titania Zuvezdina. Broadcasting for Contemporary Media. Rui Barbosa. Avery Batho. Joshua Benoit. Dwayne Braithwaite. Regal Marie Bridge. Andrea Colasso. Ryan Cohen. Lauren Crummy, highest ranking graduate. Stevon Cyrus. Selena Daywood. Philip La Rosa. Taylor Maidley. Michael Major. Quinn Marr. Christopher McKee. Sammy Palta. Cole Sauer. Naima Truroby. Francis Villaria. Jessica White. Jonathan Zagrodnik.
Contemporary Web Design. Brandon Beninato. Bruce Brophy, highest ranking graduate. Alice Vieira. Courtney Davey. Joshua Lorich. Moya Goleski. Chi Lai. Holly Nell. Aditi Mali. Kashbu Parekh. Tyler Treasure. Digital Photography. Flynn Badgley. Marley Baker. Darius Binnenost. Sabrina Caruso. Lin No Chandaran. Caitlin Coombs. Shandy Lee Cox. Marielle Davidson. Matthew Diott. Hazel Edgercito. Victoria Evans. Renee Flood-Martal. Yan King Go. Nikki Henry. Aaron Hornby. Jolene Hubbard. Samantha Dewar. Abby Catheria. Tessa Laframboise. Jacqueline Lance. Robert Long. Alexandra Lovegrove. Matthew Mangra. Jade McGinnis. Daniel Presley Spinks is receiving two diplomas this morning, one for digital photography, the second for digital video production. Syed Rizvi. Leia Serfati. Jordan Smith. Elisa Spenlow.
Digital video production. Cassidy Albricchio. Chris Altcroft. Mason Beatty. Stephanie Bloomer. Josiah Bokelin. Matthew Delaney. Kevin Gauthier. Yakub Janem. Catherine Graham. Catherine is receiving two diplomas this morning, digital video production and media fundamentals. Jesse Gray. Connor Harrison. Kevin Hamil. Rose Delore Ironsi. Amanda Laframboise. Gabriel Lau. Trevor Leahy. Margaret Grace McDougall. Peter Olivastri. Vikram Panjwani. Ryan Power. Jessica Riley. Samuel Scruton. Kaylee Sangmani. Keith Taylor, highest ranking graduate. Ethan Witten. Fine Arts Advanced. Heather Bradley. Cole Cadena DeRoche. Shelby Dutrezac. William Fortier. Cameron Graham. Heaven Ann Hooksma. Rachel Jordan. Victoria Marshall. Leslie Kunku. Catherine Pankratz. Lindsay Prosper. Caitlin Sidur. Foundations in Art and Design. Katrina Lindo. Allison Lyle. Ian Pugh. Nathaniel Sherritt. Somaya Yaramadi. Game Development. Lori Anderson. Thomas Fitzjohn. Mason Meisel. Jansen Urbitz-Tondo.
Graphic Design. Ryan Boomsma. Emily Clark. Darren Couch. Aaron Cronin. Jordan Crooks. Bruce Cuthbert. Josh Del Vecchio. Caitlin Arrington, highest ranking graduate. Aaron Fitzsimmons. Leah Francis. Sabrina Harlos. Laura Hode. Jasmine Isidoro. Emily Caljuvi. Jillian Kane. Sally Kudla. Sally's diploma will be presented by her mother, Sandra Kudla, professor. Serena Lemaire. Rebecca Lindgren. Holina Millington. Aaron Muldoon. Christine Persaud. Andrea Serrano. Christine Stewart. Amanda Stuckless. Jessica Swigger. Thanesh Theneswaran. Michael Whalen. Interactive Media Design. Braden Anderson. Journalism, Broadcast and Electronic Media. Logan Caswell. Vasilios Christou. David Conti. Noor Ibrahim, highest ranking graduate. Xenophone Catratus. Laura Metcalf. Nicole O'Brien. Sam Adrowski. Samuel's diploma will be presented by his mother, Sandy Adrowski, professor. Uvula Thomas. Brandy Washington.
Journalism, Web and Print. Jen Amaro. Rebecca Calzavera. Dean Daly. Travis Fortnum. Barbara Howe, highest ranking graduate. Daniel Kohler. Tommy Morais. Trisha Patel. Cameron Popwell. Alex Ross. Tyler Searle. Jessica Stoik. Toby Van Westen. Jared Williams. Media Fundamentals. Charles Humber. Marco Pereira, highest ranking graduate. Rebecca Sparrow. Music Business Administration. Eric Allen. Cassandra Amo. Highest ranking graduate. Haley Baskerville. Joshua Bone. Osbert Vishwa Lyle. Lauren McFarlane. Adrian McLaughlin. Leslie Ann Niles. Daniela Taro. Jazz Woodruff. Music Business Management. Danny Beidel. Kale Crow. Mike DeSavin. Justin Dollimore. Rebecca Flynn. Anissa Jones. Matthew Lane. Monica McKenna. Matthew McNeil. Alan Mock. Veronique Monjone. Ashley Puddick. Brittany Watkins. Cole Woolley, highest ranking graduate. Julia Zametti. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes our graduates from the School of Media, Arts, and Design.
For the graduates who are unable to be here this morning, we grant them their credentials in absentia. I would now like to ask the 2017 graduating class to stand and be recognized. Ladies and gentlemen, our 2017 graduating class. Graduates, please be seated. Before I close, I would like to thank all the deans, associate deans, and professors who joined us for this morning's celebration. There are many people involved in helping our students along their journey to graduation, and professors play a significant role. It is through their expertise our students learn the skills they need to succeed. These lessons happen through teaching and mentoring both in and outside of the classroom. Seeing their graduates graduate is accumulation of their hard work, and I know they're filled with pride as they watch today's ceremony, witnessing those students crossing the convocation stage, an accomplishment that could not be achieved without their guidance and support. I will now ask all faculty in attendance to please stand and be recognized for their contribution to our students' success. Thank you. And to our graduates, I say congratulations on the successful completion of your academic credential. I'll now call upon our Master of Ceremonies, Mary Kim Oliver.
Thank you, Eileen. In closing, I'd like to offer a heartfelt thank you to our Board of Governors, employees, and community partners for their contribution to the success of our graduates. Thanks also to Cassette Kazarian, Larissa Strong, and Tom Lynch for assisting with the reading of the names, all of the colleagues and friends from Durham College who participated in this morning's ceremony, Piper Allen McPhee, and the Tribute Community Centre. In addition, I would like to extend a big thank you to our Executive Director and Registrar, Paul Bishop, and his entire team for the countless hours that go into the successful planning and execution of today's convocation. And finally, congratulations, graduates. We wish you the very best as you start the next journey in your lives. I now declare the Durham College 2017 Spring Convocation to be concluded. Please remain at your seats as the platform party leaves the stage.
Hope when you take that jump, don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Give it all you had, and I hope when the moment comes, you'll say, I live. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. I'll say I swear I live. I swear I live. you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay.
I'll say